Just want to make, just say one thing, because it's really, really important, is that we've got our practice, okay? Practice is postures, is Panyana breath regulation, is Dharana or mental concentration, accountable meditation. We've got meditation on breath. So we have those practices. Asana, pranayama, dharana, leading into meditation. But that practice, even though we need to do that practice daily, that practice only takes up a certain amount of time. Whatever, that whole practice can be done. Asana, pranayama, and meditation. It can be done within a period of about 25 minutes, 30 minutes. Can be done in that time. Yeah? You guys have got handouts, you've got the manuals, you know, the room which does that. 5 minutes on, 10 minutes on asana, just stretching, and 5-10 minutes on pranayama, and 15 minutes on meditation. There you go. So, it's allowing that amount of time to practice. Now, that's that amount of time, you know, say roughly 25-30 minutes is minimum. That's your minimum practice time. But if you do that regularly, if you do it daily, regularly, that's good. Okay, if you don't do it daily, you miss a day for some reason or another, that's okay. All right. And then you go back to it the next day. Or if you miss a couple of days, you go back to it again. But you always go back to it. Until it just becomes an ingrained habit. It's just what you do. Like you clean your teeth. You do your yoga practice. Just like that. Just becomes habitual. The mind becomes habituated to it when you miss it. When you don't do it, you really miss it. You miss something in your day. Okay, that's your practice. But you've also got the rest of your day. You've got the other 20-something hours or the hours that are awake, yeah? So, you don't want to waste that time, because that's a big majority of your life, your day, of your life. So you use that time for practice. And how you practice during your everyday life, when you're driving the car, when you're at work, when you're whatever you're doing, you stay aware of your breath. Stay aware of your inhalation and exhalation. The natural, normal breath, inhalation and exhalation. You can attach the meditation, which is Sa on the breath, Om on the exhalation, Sa Om. You can attach that to your breath silently. Of course, you're doing this mentally. When you're involved in everyday activities, watching television. Still be aware of your in-breath and your out-breath. Attach sa, while you walk down the street. So you are keeping your attention focused inwardly, even if you do it with external things. At first it might seem a little artificial, it might seem a bit artificial, a bit awkward. Over a period of time, you become, your whole organism becomes habituated to that, to in tune with the breath and the mantra. the time your breath slows down. Breath out, breath in, breath slows down. Naturally, you don't have to think about it. When your breath slows down, the nervous system slows down. Your brain slows down. Your thought balls slow down. So, and so there's a stillness within. And also, if you stay in tune with your breath, in tune with the mantra, you won't get so directly caught up in external things that are happening around you. You won't respond in the same way. You won't get drawn out of yourself. You won't lose yourself, in other words. How many times do we lose ourselves in a situation, lose ourselves in relation to other people? We've got no self. It's like the situation or the other person has sucked ourselves out of ourselves. We've got no core there. So staying with the breath and the mantra, you develop a core. And it's like, it feels like a physical core, a physical center here. It feels like that. It's not physical. But it's a center of energy, because below our physical energy, there's a much more subtle subtle forms of energy. And so we're tuning into that more subtle flow of energy within our body, which is. It doesn't become more subtle. Our awareness of it becomes more subtle, and able to. In meditation, you see the energy lines within your own mind. You'll see the energy lines of your whole body. You'll see the chakras. You'll see the centers of energy. Every body. This is every. Every elderly, when they get to a certain point in the process. So your vision becomes internal. So as we have external vision, we see things around us, you see things around us. At that point, you know, the subtle senses kick in, the subtle senses of hearing, vision, taste, sight, sound. So you hear inner sound. Inner taste, you smell in the smells. But they're very heightened. They're not there like external senses. The external sense quality is pretty dead quality. It's very high. Internal senses are very high. It's the essence of smell. It's the essence of vision. It's the essence of it. It's not using an instrument. All these things can happen down the track. Those sort of psychic powers and all that sort of stuff can all appear. So you see things, you know things. My guru, Prakashananda, he was totally aware of what everybody was thinking at every second, every single person at every second. Constantly. He did. So, now, I just wanted to make that point about practice. Practice isn't just sitting on the bar.